Merhabalar. İstanbul'un ilk dijital İpek Yolu konferansına hoş geldiniz. We're finally doing it. Now, because we have a lot of international friends, I'm going to continue the rest of my talk in English, but we have interpretation, translation out there in the back. Thank you to that. Welcome to the first TEDx Silk Road Conference in Istanbul. I'm really happy that we're all here today, and thank you all for joining us. My name is Ferhan Cook, and I'm the organizer of this event. I'm not the only person who did that, of course. There's multiple people behind it. But I will be your host today. TED and TEDx conferences, I'm sure you all know about TED, which is the big conference that happens twice a year about ideas worth sharing. And TEDx conferences are the local extension of that, and there are 3,000 TEDxes all around the world, so I'm happy that I'm finally doing one too. But TEDx conferences are different from regular business conferences in that these are about ideas we're sharing and spreading. They're also about personal stories and inspirational ideas, and I think we'll hear lots of those today. So this conference is about going beyond your borders to achieve your goals. It's about creativity and about finding your purpose. It's about entrepreneurship, and it's also the real purpose of this whole conference. It's a call to action on technology-powered social entrepreneurship using mobile and internet. Now, that's a mouthful, and we'll learn a lot about that in the second module in the afternoon. And the traditions and the practices of the old Silk Road actually do provide a great background and a metaphor for all of these concepts. That's what I learned after 3 years of thinking about this. Silk Road was a long journey of trade, but also it was of cultural sharing. It was of spreading ideas, beliefs, and regions. 3,000 kilometers from China to Italy, through the mountains and through the sea, and people have gone through a lot of difficulty to sell their goods, and our first speaker will say a lot about that in the next module. So we've designed the conference as a one-day journey, as we took this word of journey as a metaphor, and we designed a one-day journey into the future of digital innovation and creativity. So journey is a rich word with a lot of meanings. Journey is a route. Journey is how you learn and how you reinvent yourself. Journey is experience. And as Steve Jobs once said in the early days of Apple, the journey is the reward. And you have it all in the backs of your badges too. I couldn't help myself. This motto of the conference is, the journey is the reward. So we all want you to enjoy the journey. So I want to begin by sharing with you the story of the TEDx Silk Road and my own personal story and my journey associated with that. I was born and raised here, graduated from Robert College in Boğaziçi, left Turkey for adventures in America like everyone else did in 1975. Now you know how old I am. I went to Hawaii, then I went to California. I worked at Apple Computer for 11 years in Silicon Valley. And now I'm living in Istanbul and London, half and half with my family. So I made the jump from the east to the west in the early age of 23. I went far to Hawaii, Japan, America, met lots of people, went on adventure. I went from Asia in the East-West Center in Hawaii. Little did I know that I was going to embark on an East-West conference 30 years later in Istanbul. Then I entered Apple in California, which changed the course of my career. Being in the same close magnetic field with Steve Jobs and all of the new PC revolution that was going on in Silicon Valley during those times actually formed a lot of my career choices going forward. Always wanting to be at the cutting edge of technology and finding cool stuff and, you know, doing things in a perfectionist way, sometimes being a control freak and so on. Then after 15 years in the US, I started making my return to the West, from West to the East again. So my story is East to the West, adjusting to that, then I'm coming West to the East again. But that took 20 years, where I was expatriated by Apple to Paris, where I worked as the head of applications publishing for handheld devices. So after Apple, all these years, I've been consulting and transporting and designing global television conferences. But I needed something more than this after all these years. It was not meaningful to explain digital media business models to people over and over again in those conferences. I needed something different, and I wanted to come home, finally. So this is my coming home, actually. And that's when I went to, before I came home, I went to TED India in 2009, which really inspired me, and it struck me like a lightning that I was really inspired. And I've been traveling around the world to do my job, to Japan, Korea, France, Italy, and I'm always searching for creativity, and I'm always looking for digital creativity, cutting-edge things. So I realized that I've been actually working on some sort of Silk Road journey and ideas all my life. To do a TED event, you need a local place and a name to name your next TEDx. But what I did do, just instinctively, I called it TEDx Silk Road. I don't know why. I just called it TEDx Silk Road. It was sexy, and the name and concept stuck with people, so I went with it. But I did not know that I was getting myself into a three-year exploration, because it was huge. I just didn't know. I didn't know how to get my head around it. After researching several concepts, we finally settled on borderless creativity and commerce, because this is what we're all doing, actually. We're all trying to go beyond our borders. We can't fit the boundaries of a nation, even though we all feel Turkish or American or Japanese. We can't fit the boundaries that our national borders give us, or a particular job gives us. Like, if I'm an accountant, I want to also be a singer. Or a particular role in life. We all want to be freed of these borders. And you know that technology, among other things, helps us with this, and our own creativity helps us with that. So even content wants to set itself free and with the help of technology. So the journey of preparing the Silk Road Conference has been a parallel journey for me of coming home in many levels. As the Portuguese literary Nobel Prize winner author José Saramago puts it, I'm going to say this in Turkish because it's beautiful. Yolculuk hiç bitmez. Ne zaman yorgun vardığın bir deniz kıyısındaki kumsalda artık görecek bir şey yok dediğinde bunun doğru olmadığını bil. Daha göreceklerinin yanı sıra baharda gördüğün yeri yazın, gündüz gördüğünü gece de görmelisin. Güneşin her gün bir başka doğuşuna, olgunlaşmış meyveye, yer değişen taşa ve gölgelere bir daha bakmalısın. Yeni bir yol bulmak için, yeni başlangıçlar için başladığın yere dönmen ve yeniden yol alman gerekir. And I think that's what I'm doing personally here. I've come home to reinvent myself, to go on a new direction. And this new direction is defined by this conference, because this conference has a true objective of starting technology-empowered social entrepreneurship. And it's a one-day kickoff, but I hope that a lot more of it will come. So I'm going to cut short now. Why Silk Route? The old Silk Route was a route of commerce and innovation which delivered goods and spread innovation from east to west and west to east through long journeys. Music, storytelling, cultural sharing of beliefs, traditions accompanied the commerce. But the traditions of 2,000 years ago still remain. Commerce fuels creativity and innovation, and the route to innovation resembles the long and arduous winter journeys of the old Silk Road. This is a day where you will hopefully find new inspiration and information, and you will network and share ideas with future colleagues and friends, and hopefully you will take home with you some learnings and new ideas. I want to thank all of our sponsors and partners and friends who helped make this day a reality, but I will thank them later properly. For now, let's get on with the show.